Greece has announced its intention to acquire 18 Rafales to equip its air force. This announcement illustrates the strength of the partnership that has linked the Greek Air Force and Dassault Aviation for more than 45 years and demonstrates the enduring strategic relationship between Greece and France. Greece ordered 40 Mirage F1 from Dassault Aviation in 1974, then 40 Mirage 2000 in 1985, and finally 15 Mirage 2005 in the year 2000. This latest contract also includes the modernization of 10 Mirage 2000 to the 2005 standard with a large contribution from the Greek industry. Greece is shielded with 18 Rafale aircraft as announced at September 12, 2020 on Thessaloniki International Fair podium by the Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis. In particular, Hellenic Prime Minister in terms of armaments noted that the time has come to strengthen the military and announced 6 key decisions, among which the Hellenic Air Force acquires 18 Rafale, that which replaced the previous Mirage aircraft, which in combination with the F-16 will fully protect Greece. To get in detail with this particular important information and various other considerable Indian and international inputs, let us begin with today's defense updates of 14th of September 2020. Hello and welcome to SSB Crack Exams. We are one-stop solution for you if you are preparing for various defense examinations. I highly recommend you to download our Android app from Google Play Store and follow us on all sorts of social media platforms. And even if you download our Android app, it will always help you in your preparation so that you get your uniform of dreams. Beginning with the question of the day that I have posted on 12th of September, on Saturday. And the question that I asked was, who was the Chief of Air Staff of India during Kargil War? I repeat the question, who was the Chief of Air Staff of India during Kargil War? And everybody has given a correct answer. He is Air Chief Marshal Anil Yashwant Tipnis. I repeat, Air Chief Marshal Anil Yashwant Tipnis, PVSM, AVSM, VM, ADC. He served as the Chief of Air Staff of Indian Air Force from 31st of December 1998 to 31st of December 2001. And Kargil War happened in 1999 and he was a very major important personality in the Kargil War. He commanded the Air Force to distinction during the Kargil War and when the force flew air superiority missions and close air support at the heights of over 18,000 feet. To get in detail regarding his education is at Barnes School at Diwali. After his schooling, he joined the NDA Pune in January of 1956 and he was commissioned as a fighter pilot from the National Defence Academy on 28th of May 1960. He even served with the 1st Supersonics, the 28th Squadron. After the war, Tipnis was deputed to the Iraq as a pilot attack instructor. Also to get in detail that he even attended the Staff College course at Defence Services Staff College. He also took the command of 23rd Squadron equipped with MiG-21 Bisons and was also shortlisted as one among the 4 Intercosmos Space Program, that was a program of Russian space program. And after that, he also commanded the Air Force Station Gwalior when he was the Air Commodore. And this particular Air Force Station Gwalior was equipped with Mirage 2000 at those times. On promotion to a 2-star rank, he even was appointed as the Assistant Chief of Air Staff of Inspection at Air Headquarters. He later took over as Air Officer Commanding in Chief of the Jammu and Kashmir area. He even served as the Senior Air Staff Officer SASO of the Eastern Air Command and of the Western Air Command. And he was then moved to Air Headquarters and served as the Vice Chief of Air Staff before taking over as the 18th Chief of Air Staff. This is a very brief introduction of the complete career of the Air Chief Marshal Anil Yashwant Tipnis. Now let us begin with the first and foremost important defense update. And the first defense update is that India and US have held 2+2 intersessional meet and they discussed ties and regional developments. And this meeting was held virtually on Friday. Indian delegation was led jointly by Vani Rao, who is the Joint Secretary in the Ministry of External Affairs, and Somnath Ghosh, who is the Joint Secretary of the International Cooperation in the MOD. Regarding the from the US side, US delegation was led jointly by Dean Thompson, who is the Senior Bureau Official of the Bureau of South and Central Asian Affairs in the US Department of State, and David Helvey, who is the Acting Assistant Secretary for Indo-Pacific Security Affairs in the US Department of Defense. Both the important personalities from the India and US have discussed the ties between United States of America and India, and both of them have discussed the 2+2 dialogues that were done in the year of 2019 and the progress that has been done until this particular year, until yesterday. Going through with the next important defense update is Greece has announced its intention to acquire 18 Rafales to equip its air force. This is what I was discussing with you in the introduction session. So in particular, the Hellenic Prime Minister, who is he? The Prime Minister of the Greece, he is Kyriakos Mitsotakis. In terms of the armaments, noted that the time has come to strengthen the military and announced 6 key decisions, among which Hellenic Air Force acquires 18 Rafale, that which replaced the previous Mirage aircraft, which in combination with F-16 will fully protect Greece. Now is that these 18 Rafale aircrafts and these F-16s that are already in service with the Hellenic Air Force, all of them will in combination will protect the Greece aerospace. Going through with the next important update is that India is in talks for logistics packs with Russia, United Kingdom and Vietnam. Regarding the Russia and Vietnam, UK and Vietnam, both of them have still not yet begun, but they are under discussion. But regarding the discussion with Russia, the Reciprocal Logistics Support, the ARLS, is expected to be signed during the bilateral summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and President Vladimir Putin in mid-October. And Roman Babushkin, who is the Deputy Chief of Mission at the Russian Embassy in India, he said and he informed this particular information to us this particular week, and the agreement will give India access to the Russian facilities in the Arctic region. Understanding? So from this particular agreement, we will have a hand over the Russian facilities in the Arctic region. Thereby, we are improving our global presence. Going through with the next important update is that stay away from the politics or face consequences. This warning was given by Hizbul Mujahideen to the Jammu and Kashmir leaders. This was given, the threat was issued through a written letter written in Urdu on the proscribed terror group's letterhead, as said by the officials of the police and the security officers of the Jammu and Kashmir area. And it was a 2-page letter and it was signed by self-styled divisional commander of the Hizbul. Regarding this particular information, that this particular letter particularly aims on giving a warning towards the minister, who is the Minister of State, the Jitendra Singh. And along with him, who is also the Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office, it also mentioned 17 senior politicians of the BJP, including the JNK BJP President Ravinder Raina, the National Conference Provincial President Devinder Singh Rana, Dogra Swabhiman Sangathan leader Chaudhary Lal Singh, and other former ministers, legislators, as well as the RSS functionaries also were issued this particular warning. Also to get in detail that that letter, as it read that we warn you to renounce politics and support our cause for freedom, otherwise death warrants have been issued against you, no security cover will safeguard you from us, as said by the letter. This particular thing was there in the letter. So regarding all of these nonsense activities that were done, the cases were sanctioned under the sections of 121A of waging war against the government of India, section 506, which is a criminal intimidation of Indian Penal Code, and sections 13, which is unlawful activity, 16 and 18, which is a terrorist act of the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, so UAPAA of 2019, have all been registered under these. And everybody is under high alert, and each and every other important information will be provided by us in the coming updates. Going through with the next important update is Chinese PLA's new expansion plans have begun in Bhutan. According to the diplomats who are based in the Thimphu, the capital of Bhutan and New Delhi, they have said since 2017 Doklam standoff, PLA has intruded into 5 areas of the western Bhutan and laid claim to a new boundary that extends approximately 40 kilometers inside Bhutan to the east of Chumbi Valley. It has methodically built up infrastructure, improved defenses, constructed roads, tracks, helipads for troop movement, and last mile logistics also. So this is a clear identification of how China will look after its expansionist policies. You have to also understand that Bhutan is central to India's national security, as the country lies next to the Siliguri corridor, and any territorial compromise made by Bhutan will have an adverse impact on Indian defenses in the area. Although India helped Bhutan hold its own against PLA during the 73-day standoff at Doklam Plateau in 2017, the Chinese army has not stopped testing the armies of 2 close allies in the area. The people in India's military, diplomatic and security establishment have said, speaking on the condition of the anonymity. Going through with the next important update is that Midhani masters armor that can stop AK-47 shots. What is Midhani? Midhani is Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited. Okay, it is a very, very important defense public sector enterprise of India. So this is a short form. The full form of Midhani is Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited. So it has manufactured the very, very important bulletproof jackets Whereas the speciality of these bulletproof jackets is these can also stop AK-47 shots. Okay, so these are named as Bhabha Kavach, as you can see here. So this is since the this was actually made and it was actually done under research by the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, and it was developed this technology. So giving a respect to the BARC, the Kavach was named as Bhabha Kavach, and these jackets can even stop a bullet fired from an AK-47 as well. A few hundred bulletproof jackets have already been supplied to the paramilitary forces as samples, and all of these are manufactured in Medani. They meet the specifications of Union Ministry of Home Affairs and also the BIS level 6. Going through with the next important update is Jammu and Kashmir DGP says that arms have been seized from Kulgam, which were airdropped by a drone from Pakistan, and all of these were given said. So Dilbagh Singh, who is the Director General of Jammu and Kashmir Police, on Sunday, he said that the arms and ammunition have been seized during a joint operation by police and army near Jawahar Tunnel in Kulgam on Tuesday. We are even getting complete information that Pakistan and the terrorists of the Pakistan are trying to enter into the Indian territory illegally by means of tunnels. So this was also being seized, and all the important weapons have been seized from a tunnel. So this was the Jawahar Tunnel, which was there at Kulgam, and on Tuesday they were airdropped in Samba sector with the help of a drone from the Pakistan side. Investigation into the seizure is in progress, as he said, adding that Jammu has never been out of the radar of Pakistan. That is it regarding today's important defense updates. Now we will have a very quick review. And the first and foremost question is, Director General of the Jammu and Kashmir Police is, he is Dilbagh Singh. We just now discussed this particular information. Going through with the next important question is, which country announced its intention to acquire 18 Rafales to equip its air force? That country is Greece. Okay. So going through with the next and the final important question is, the bulletproof jackets which are manufactured by Medani, the Mishra Dhatu Nigam Limited, are named as what? They are named as the Bhabha Kavach. Now we will have the question of the day, and the question of the day for today is, who proposed the plan and was responsible in the formation of the Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry Regiment? I repeat the question, who proposed the plan and was responsible in the formation of the Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry Regiment? The answer for this and the complete details regarding this particular question and the person, I will be giving you in the next session. Until then, stay tuned. This is Big Crack Exams. Subscribe to this channel. Download our Android app from Google Play Store. Always stay safe, stay healthy, keep smiling. Jai Hind.